Oftentimes, I hear people saying stuff like, I'm not good at anything, I don't know if I really have any potential to do something worth my while or not, I'm not even a good student, how can I be good at something else, nobody appreciates me for anything I do, people call me loser, I really want to do something but I don't know what that thing actually is, and plenty of other questions like these. The answer to all such questions is that I believe if not many, every person has that one special potential that makes him different from all the others. In order to know about it, what we do is just sit back and think of it all day long instead of working for it and end up being depressed if we couldn't find one. Don't just waste yourself in thinking and waiting for the right time, rather make use of every second you are bestowed with. Critically analyzing yourself based on the activities you love to do, the people you wish to be around, and the field you wanted yourself to be in may prove beneficial for you in tracing your path. What most of us do is that we look for the trends and scopes of anything we do. Now for this, I would suggest you to be the trendsetter, who in simple words is called a psycho. To be a trendsetter, you really don't have to do an invention because you are not a scientist, but a human being who is superior than all the other creations of Almighty. So just be yourself, as you are unique in your own way. Do it the way you like it, follow your heart, and the world will ultimately follow you. Next thing is to take calculated risks. What I mean by that is whatever you do, just do it with all your heart, mind and soul by knowing the favorable and adverse effects it might have on your life in the long run. As for now, most of us are dependent on our parents, but at the same time, no one is dependent on us, which means we are independent to try out several new things. And you never know, during the whole process of experimenting, you get to have your potentials known. All you need to do is to put 110% of your efforts, but be prepared for the worst and the best outcomes. Simply buck yourself up to keep on working hard for the thing that makes you happy and contented from within, rather than overloading your mind with the backup plans you might have thought of. Leaving one thing incomplete and preferring the other thing is never going to get you where you always wanted to be. Also, it is very important for you to surround yourself with the positive ones who would never judge you for anything you do. Rather, they would stand by your side all along the journey of self-discovery and hard work. Be the influencer, not the one influenced by the criticism around. Don't be afraid of what others would say about your work. Just take it as, if someone is talking about your life pessimistically, it doesn't mean that you are doing something wrong. It just means that you have started your journey and now others are getting influenced by whatever you do. Most of the times it happens that the things we keep on restricting ourselves from proves to be a hidden talent revolving around our unknown potentials. So be open to whatever comes your way, whether it's something big or small. Just don't restrict yourself and doubt your potentials as to what you can do and what you cannot. You have a life to live, not to pass. Then why not explore your curiosities and play around with the reasons of your existence? Make opportunities for others by guiding them, or by sharing your knowledge and experiences instead of feeling insecure to see others progressing. And you might end up finding something more of your interest. Spread positivity and productivity, as being bored in the house is merely not the solution to any of your problems. Stay calm, as you will get your potentials known.